Welcome back to another video. In this video, we are going to solve a lab modifying serialized data types in which behind the backend server, there is the PHP who handles the comparison between an access token and the access token stored into the browser. But we need to exploit this server passing through the logic of the PHP, which could be vulnerable for this kind of manipulation due to the behavior that it has. If we go through this int of the lab, quirky now PHP, and we search it on Google, we find an article made by Vicky Lee, in which there is some explanation about this topic, in particular the type juggling and type cohesion, because usually if there is two different data types, PHP will compare it and we will try to convert the string in case there is a comparison between an integer and a string. It will convert it, in this case, with the zero value. So if we use the zero and we compare it with the string, we will get the true output. So this could allow us to access some determinate user in order to get to the admin panel. So let's use the cookie string in which there is stored and embedded in an object in base64 encoded, where we can find the common structure that we saw in the previous lab, in which there is two main variables, username and access token. In this case, the username is set to Winer and the access token is the one corresponding to him. To modify the object, we need to put the right number of length for each variable. So we can use these two programs to find out the current length of the string in a quick way. So let's test for administrator. And as you can see, the length is 14, but we need to place 13 because the value goes from 0 to 13. And in the access token, let's change the value with the integer and the number. We place 0. And if we encode this string to base64 and we place it into the cookie jars of the web browser, we will be able to access the admin panel. But I would like to let you see another way to perform this lab, because in this case, if we use this object and we place a wrong access token, there is an error that which is not handled, because it will output us all the access token strings available on the backend server. So as you can see, if we copy this cookie into the web browser, we will get these three access tokens, which are for administrator, Winer, and Carlos respectively. And if we use this one and we verify also the length to be sure to put the right value, and we place it into the object and we encode it another time, we will be able to access the admin panel and delete the user Carlos. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe. See you soon with other videos.